amen, so you know you didn't plant on love, but you just want to shut their mouths. And then there are some times, amen, when we just really legitimately cannot keep that promise. I can't be there because they just called and told me I got to come in for work. Amen. You know I got to go to work, amen, because a man don't work, don't eat. Amen. Lord, so that's a reason. But God always keeps his promise. Amen. God never tells us a lie. Because a lie is not in him. Amen. He always keeps his promise. Now you can tell the pastor, Pastor, we're going to be a Bible study this week. Amen. And the pastor goes, all right, I'm looking for you. And he's looking for you. Amen. And you don't come and you don't call. Amen. He's going to be wondering if you told a lie. Amen. Amen.
Lord. He's going to steal, kill, and destroy. Amen. He doesn't want you to have your new season. He doesn't want you to have your best life. He doesn't know what you're going to be blessed with. He doesn't know the mind of God, but he knows the rest in his own way. So this is why he tells you this morning. Amen. You know what? You're not feeling well this morning. Why don't you just stay in? You work all week and all week and all day Saturday. You need to stay in and just rest your body. Because see, the devil knows that if you come to the house of the Lord today, there's a blessing. Amen. He knows when you got up this morning, you had a pass your body. Amen. But when you got back home, amen, the pain was gone because you shouted that pain out here in the service. Amen. He knows that your deliverance is in this place. Amen. So he's going to keep you from being in this place. He's going to tell you to stay home, and he's going to get Christ to come to church. Listen, the devil goes to church. Listen, I'm just going to put it like this. The Lord has some things in store for this church. This church cannot afford to get tired. Because God is about to send an abundance of rain in this place. He's about to send his helpers to the ministry. Listen, I see there's another name on the building. But he's going to bless you with a building with your name on it. Because when there's another name on the building, then there's a time frame that you can use it. But he's going to give you a building when there's no time limit attached to it. It's already in the works. Oh. It's already in the works. Pastor's already working on it. All I said to mention is 6 to 8 months, something's going to turn. Somebody say he's turning. It's tedious because you have been weary. Because you have not taken down when the enemy wanted you to give up. Because you stayed on the wall. God is getting ready to bless you in abundance. It's not always about the money, but God will not let faithfulness go on the wall.
Anybody. And you've just been silent, the Lord's gonna make a way, the Lord's gonna make a way, the Lord's already made a way.
According to his riches.
A lot of folks have turned their backs and closed the door on you. And there were times you set up in your house. First you got mad. Hey, Lord. First you got mad, but you didn't tell the Lord, Lord, take this from me, because I don't want to feel like this. You know, all the other men know you, man, and your little wife.